Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, touching every heart. I worship you, I worship you.
More.
and I'll provide the sacrifice. If you provide your spirit, then I will open up and say, if you provide your fire, sacrifice. If you provide your spirit, I will open up inside. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. If you provide the fire, then I'll provide the sacrifice. If you provide your spirit, then I will open up inside. If you provide your fire, I'll provide the sacrifice. If you pour out your spirit, then I will open up inside. Just one more of you. Fill me up more of.
in the waters of baptism, Ian died in Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory.
Come here today to celebrate. Amen?
Yeah.
For us as Christians, we believe that this is but a stepping stone to what God holds in store for us. And so when we come together like this, we come together in tremendous faith and trust that the life of our brother, the life he has lived, that would have been sufficient to take him into his eternal reward. And so faith says to us, we could celebrate this moment because of the mercy and love of God towards us. Amen?
Amen.
At this time, we may sit for a few moments as we listen to the eulogy.
Hi, good morning. Well, first of all, thank you for everyone for making the drive to come up. I know it's a long drive. Family, friends, well, I think out of everything that I would have had to do for this occasion, writing the eulogy was the hardest part because it's coming to accept that he really no longer here with me. So, this is a brief, I guess, synopsis, summary of what Dad was to me and others he would have met. So, again, hello everyone. Again, my name is Kay, son of Boston Monsegue. I want to start off by thanking you all for coming out today to celebrate my father's riveting life. My father was a little man and logical thinker, always coming up with plans or ideas for his journey through life. He would always be willing to help aid any cause which would better those around him or himself. And he believed in education and discipline. Can discipline a lot. I would test these boundaries religiously, so I would know what he stood for. He transitioned from being a sailor to a teacher, and then even more so, more influence or more importance would have been placed on education now. A little bit. Okay, sorry. Now more than ever. I could remember once I was just finished CXE or approaching CXE, and I asked Dad, I said, Dad, I could go out tonight? Tell me no. I don't really like no. So I took it upon myself to leave the man house. I thought I was safe, you know, I had a good time. Came back. I saw him packing the van to go to Toco. So this was about 5 o'clock in the morning. I saw him packing the van to go to Toco. So I timed him and said, well, when he turns his back, I'll run up the hill. So he turned his back. I thought I got through. And then coming through the window, my mom coming to bring tea for me. My mom said, nah, run back outside. And well, as how they saying, all hell break loose. Daddy come in that room and remind me of the discipline he stood for. And then on top of that, took me to Toco to work with him. And in between my dad and Uncle Eamon, and the statement was, don't sleep there, you know. And he said, if you only sleep, cut your tail with a whip and make you take a sea bath. But in all that, it did motivate me. You know, at one point I said, nah boy, this man too serious. Now I can't go in no service and work. Now this, if that's how you're ending up, I can't be so. As fate would have it, God had other plans for me. But I can remember also on a Saturday morning, late sleeping wasn't allowed. So at about 7, 8, you would hear, time to get up. He would take me outside and would throw me little things, like, you know, how to be handy around the house. At the time, I didn't see its benefits, but now I can see that all these little situations and incidents grew me to the person I am today. And I would really, really always remember my father for that. I don't know how long it will take me to grieve this loss, this tremendous loss, but my father really was an integral part of my development, and I feel heartbroken to no longer have him here with me, with us. But I will ensure his memories and all that he stood for will forever carry on. And all the plans that we would have discussed together, promise you that we will see it through. Right? And again, I want to thank everyone for coming here today.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, who have strengthened us by the mystery of the cross and promise us a share in the mystery of your Son's resurrection, mercifully grant, we pray, that your departed servant Ian may be gathered into the company of your chosen ones. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the first reading.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like this, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with him, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin, for a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him.
We know that the power of Christ has risen, and from the dead he dies no more, with death no longer has the power over him. And this is the word of the Lord.
Don't you ever
Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus journeyed to a city called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd accompanied him. As he drew near to the gate of the city, a man who had died was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. A large crowd from the city was with her. When the Lord saw her, he was moved with pity for her, and he said to her, "Do not weep." He stepped forward and touched the coffin. At this, the bearers halted, and he said, "Young man, I tell you, arise." The dead man sat up and began to speak, and Jesus gave him to his mother. Fear seized them all, and they glorified God, exclaiming, "A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people." This report about him spread through the whole of Judea and all the surrounding region. The Gospel, the good news of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Welcome,
Christ.
Holy Spirit.
Welcome, Holy Spirit.
Tremendous love and mercy. We thank you, O God, for bringing us together to celebrate the life of our brother Ian. Even now we ask that your Holy Spirit will fill our hearts and our minds, that we will be receptive, open to receive your word. Through Christ our Lord we pray. Amen. So good morning once again, brothers and sisters. I want to invite you to do something this morning. Just take a moment and become aware of the people, the person you are sitting next to, the person who might be behind you, in front of you, at your side. Just look around for a moment. Yes, you're seeing some people you didn't see for a while, okay? Just be aware. How did you feel in your heart?
And I'm talking about the guy who stared into the young lady's eye. Yeah? Alright? But how did you feel? If that person sitting next to you was the cough, how would you feel? That one is so free. Jesus is walking through the community of Nain. And Jesus is very conscious of his surroundings. He's very much aware as to what is happening in the lives of people. And when we read the Gospels, you would see that things that would not normally bother his disciples or the scribes or the Pharisees, Jesus takes note of it. Amen? And so, it demonstrates the heart and the love that Jesus has for the people that surrounds him. Because of his tremendous love and mercy, he's always looking. He's always seeing. He's always listening. And so he's very conscious of the needs of others. And because he's so conscious, and because he's so filled with love, and because he has a deep desire for life abundantly for everyone, he steps out, as it were, out of his comfortable zone and attends to the need of the other. Amen? And so we hear this woman this morning is about to lay her son to rest. He has died. She's also a widow. And if you know anything about the time in which Jesus lived, you would understand that women had no say. Women had no voice. They were marginalized. They were left locked up, as it were, in the cupboards. Children were considered to be a distraction. Hence the story when the children comes to Jesus and the disciples begin to shoo them away, as it were. Huh? And Jesus says, no. Suffer little children to come unto me. Jesus is not only seeing the present moment of pain for this woman in the loss of her son, but he sees beyond the body that is in front of him. What Jesus was seeking to do for this woman in this reading was to restore to her a sense of dignity, a sense of purpose, to give her a reason once again for living, to give her again, as it were, a voice, because the only voice a woman would have in the society at that time would be the voice of her husband, her father, or her son. Amen? And so Jesus is seeking to restore life here. It is not just the physical life, but the emotional, the psychological, the sense of well-being for this woman, that she does not have to stay locked up in the cupboard, as it were, but that she could experience, as Jesus would say elsewhere in the scriptures, life and life abundantly. Amen? My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus says it to us in John, I have come that you may have life and have it to the fullest. And all of us here, each one of us here without exception, there is a deep desire for life. Amen? Ask yourself why you go to the gym every day. Hello? Ask yourself when you feel a little sick, a headache or something, why do you go to the doctor? Or you run to Father Raymond to pray for you. Eh? Because innate to all of us is a desire for life. Amen? It's a desire to live and to experience life in all its fullness. And if we are good Trinis, we would think, well, life in all its fullness is a good Carnival Monday and Tuesday, right? Hello? Well, that's just a little peep through the window. If you think that's the fullness of life, wait until you have an encounter, an experience of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because you see, my dear brothers and sisters, the scriptures reminds us, as human beings, we crave. And as I said, that craving is really for life. But somehow, we misplace that craving. That desire for fulfillment, that desire for joy, it is misplaced in terms of where we seek to satisfy it. The scriptures reminds us that life, that joy, comes through no other than the person of Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen? I'm not hearing that. Amen, amen. We're not convinced. And we all know, we live our lives. We have everything that we need. We have the big house, the big car, the bank account is fat, the nicest woman sitting on your right, and the other lady on the left. And somehow there is an emptiness. Somehow we are not satisfied. Somehow there is a longing that something is missing. As St. Augustine would say to us, we are created in such a way as human beings that there is the hole in the chest. And he says that hole is created in such a way that none other than God himself could fit that hole and bring the kind of satisfaction and fulfillment we desire. So I have one drink and I have two drinks and I drink the bottle. What happened? I get up with a hangover tomorrow. I sleep. I take a bath, maybe in the beach. And then tomorrow night, what happens? I'm back at it again. True or false? Huh? Hello? I'm working and I'm getting a big fat salary. The bank account is big, but somehow there's a space for more. Huh? And on the side, we go and we make our little deals. You know what I'm talking about. Because we need to fatten that account a bit more. We are married and we have our beautiful wives with us. And also the lady on the left. But we could still find room for the one in the office. Hello? And the one who is walking down the street. Hello? And that, don't stone me, I'm just saying. Because it's a natural thing. All of us, there is something, there is an emptiness that we are seeking to satisfy. And I say to us this morning, the only person who has the ability to satisfy each and every one of us without having to crave for anything else tomorrow is none other than the person of Jesus Christ. I have come that you may have life and have it abundantly. The scripture says, for God so loved the world, for God so loved you, brother, for God so loved me, Raymond, that he gave his only begotten son, so that if Raymond would believe, Raymond would not perish, but Raymond would have life abundantly. Each one of us could find a space there for our names. The heart of God is so big that each and every one of us could find our space there. And so Jesus restores the life of this little boy, and he restores the emotional, psychological, and whatever other life of his mother, giving her that sense of dignity and status in the community. That all that we desire, the big account and the nice house and the pretty lady and the enjoyment of life, God does not want to deny us of that. It comes. And anybody who is worth their salt and they are living an honest Christian life, they will tell you, it comes with some trouble, yes. But God meets us at our every point of need. And so I want to believe that the death of our brother should not go in vain. In as far as we gather here to celebrate and to hear the word of God on his behalf. He has already lived his life. Amen? And the most we can do for us as Catholics, we believe that we can pray for our loved ones that God will show mercy and grant them eternal rest. But I believe more so that this celebration, it is for you and I. To remind ourselves that one day Kongote, hello? No longer hear that one? We're going to end up here. irregardless of our status in society, my accomplishments, what I have and what I don't have, one day I am going to end up in front of an altar or maybe under a tent. But when I end up there, believe me, brothers and sisters, God is going to invite me to give an account as to how I lived my life. What was the source of the satisfaction and the contentment in your life? Was I the source? Was I sufficient? Was I the source of your every need and desire? And some of us might be able to say, well, yeah, Lord, although in some areas I try to make it up otherwise, you know, have mercy. But believe me, some of us, we would want to run away and hide. And so Ian's death gives you and I an opportunity to reflect on our lives and to ask ourselves where we are at in this journey. That if I were to die tonight or tomorrow, how would I stand before God? And if you recognize that there is anything in your life that is not at rights, that will deny you, as we would say, the beatific vision, beholding the presence of God, if there is anything there that will deny you that joy and that opportunity, allow the death of Ian to give you a moment of reflection, to give you a moment of considering your own end. And so to try to put right those things in our lives that may not be right before God. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Create in me a clean heart, O Lord, and renew a right spirit within me. Create in me a clean heart, O within me.
Let us pray. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, His Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask Him to save all His people, living and dead. The response to the intercession is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Ian, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a brother who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother Ian, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated, brothers and sisters.
And at this time, we will have a collection being taken up. And this is not something I love doing, but we are at a point in our parish in which we have to do it. So I'm asking you, please be generous in your collection this morning. Amen? God bless.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God the Father, the Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, O Lord, on your servant Ian, for whom we offer you the sacrifice of praise, humbly entreating that reconciled with you through these devoted offices, he may merit to rise again to life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for your holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Jason our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Ian, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Lord, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her the peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We share with each other that sign of peace. Peace of Christ. Peace be with you. Peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to share in the supper of the Lamb. I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep me safe for life eternal. Just a gentle reminder, brothers and sisters, that communion is reserved for those of us who are Catholics and are fully participating. Okay?
Thank you.
Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, says the Lord. And I will not reject anyone who comes to me. Let us pray. Renewed by this life-giving sacrament, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of our brother Ian, to whom you gave a part in your covenant, may be purified by the power of this mystery, and rejoice without end in the peace of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we enter into the final commendation. So at this time we have, as I said, the final commendation of our brother. And just to share a little bit as to what is going to happen, we will use holy water to bless the remains of our brother. And that water reminds us as Catholics, as Christians, that it was through the waters of baptism we were brought into the community of faith, into the family of God. Amen? Through the waters of baptism. Secondly, we would use the incense. And the incense reminds us that we are all temples of the Holy Spirit, that the living God indwells us. And then finally, we would use the dust, as it were. It was from dust we came, and to dust we shall return. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Ian. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Ian again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
our brother Ian in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Ian in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Ian, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham. And where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. May we stand for a final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our celebration of the life of our brother is ended. We go forth in the love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
I'm not sure if I should do this, but I just wanted to acknowledge the... All right. Okay. God be with you, brothers and sisters.
Thanks to you, Cindy, Father.
Amen.
I'm not afraid to so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can. Come on, let him know. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. What would happen if a generation embraced this? Come on, tell them, here I am.
Here I am.
I give myself.
are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you.
Thank you. Mark, I don't care about you. Mark, I don't care about you.
I'm going to get stuck. I was a little girl, listening to my grandfather say, "This place is not my home." God promised he was preparing a place where we would live with him forevermore, where there'd be no more crying, no more dying, no more sadness, no pain. The city of a living God, a place of unimagined blessing.
Wanna leave?
nothing more to hear you knocking at my door. 'Cause if I could see your face once more, I'd die a happy man, I'm sure.
Question only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, where God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight.